DevOps is nothing but a automating the infrastructure. Now, earlier, let's talk about 5 years back how the things are working. Like, do you have any idea what is web server, what is app server, what is database server, like that?
Yeah, a little bit.
Now, what is meant by web server? Hosting a static pages. In web server, what we do? We host static pages. In application server, what we host? We host dynamic pages. Dynamic pages means actual business logic will be executed under application servers, and whatever the pages like static data which we are storing under web servers. Got it? The main difference? Usually database. What database? Application server. Whatever the data which is receiving or inserting or whatever the thing it was, it is going to store under database server. Application and database is tightly coupled. And web server, it is for static data. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. If you, do you have any idea about 3-tier architecture? What is meant by 3-tier architecture? Guys, Ashwini, what is mean by 3-tier architecture?
3-tier architecture, actually it's a client server software architecture.
Client server architecture is 2-tier architecture.
User interface, functional, process, logic.
Okay. Ram, do you have any idea? Okay. 3-tier architecture means you have firewall. After that, you have load balancer. Whether it's a hardware load balancer or maybe a software load balancer. After that, if it's a hardware load balancer, again you have software load balancer. Then web servers. Then application servers. Then after database. If you have memcached servers, then between app servers to database servers, the memcached servers are going to be available over there. Okay, this complete setup which we can call it as 3-tier architecture. Okay, now to host a 3-tier architecture for any application, for any product, how much time it will take? Usually months of time it will take earlier, 5 years back, but now it will complete within 2 hours. How we can drastically decrease the time from months to days, sorry, hours? How we can? By implementing the DevOps tools, we can decrease the time. How means, what earlier, whatever the things which we do manually. Let's take physical. If you want to host a 3-tier architecture, first one is, the primary thing is, you need to have a servers. Okay, physical servers. After that, assemble guys are going to come and they are going to assemble it. Then storage guys are going to integrate the storage optical fibers to it. Then after, network guys are going to lay in the cables for it, and they will create VLANs, virtual LANs. These are all the setup which will take 1 month of time. And after that, operations guys are going to install operating system on top of it. Okay. After that, middleware guys are coming into the picture, and they are going to installing application on top of it. Then they are going to integrating and all the stuff. For this, it will take 2 or 3 months. But now, by learning the automation tools, we are the same task, 3 months task, which we are doing on 2 hours. Within 2 hours, the product is up and running in a production. How means? We are writing the we are learning how to work with automation tools as per the software lifecycle, as well as the provisioning perspective also. Earlier, in 10 years back, everything is running in a physical machines, not 10 to 15 years back. But the all the workloads which are shifted to virtualization. Virtualization means virtual machines. Instead of we are going to installing our applications on a physical machine, we are installing on virtual machine. That is a drastic change which has happened. After that, now containers are coming into the picture. It is very like VMs are sooner. Virtual machines are going to replace by containers. Okay, I don't want to go in depth on that particular part, but I will give you what we are learning here in this course. Okay, whole the DevOps DevOps, like I told you, right? Automation which we can use DevOps tools, we can automate the process. The whole tools are divided into two sections. You can feel free to ask me any questions. Okay, just stop me and ask if you have any doubts. The tools which are divided into continuous integration and continuous delivery. This continuous integration, there are some tools, like if you are able to see my screen, right?
Yes.
You in the mouse, this particular area is continuous integration. In this continuous integration area, we are learning Git. Git is version control system. Version control system means, I will give you a short example, then I think most of the guys are already aware of Git, but if you are not aware, I will tell you. For example, you have a team of 10 members. Okay, everyone has, that's a starting day, everyone writes some each and every file, like 10 files, 10 developers are there, they have written 10 files and they have kept it on one directory. Okay, can we say which file was developed?
Sorry
by
for developer? Interrupting.
Yeah,
sorry for interrupting. Yeah, Anadeep. Can you please ask remaining all to keep it on mute? When they want to talk, please unmute and talk. But if you are silenced, please put your mic on mute. There are a lot of disturbance.
Guys, can you please mute yourself? If you have any questions, feel free to unmute and ask me the questions, okay? Okay, let's get started.
Thanks a lot.
No problem. Okay, you can see this is a continuous integration. In the integration, we are having Git, Jenkins, Nexus, Sonar. If you come to the Git, it is a version control system. What is mean by version control system means, I will give you a short example, then you are able to understand. Let's take, we have a team of 10 members. This is the starting day and 10 developers are going to write 10 files and they are going to contribute to a, like they created a folder. And every file is going to drop in that particular folder. Now we are able to track who developed which file. Next day, they developed 10 files and they dropped, and some people modified some files among those. And third day, again, they modified some of the files. And the fourth day, are we able to say which file was modified by which person? Can we able to track the changes? No, we cannot. That's why we are going to put a Git, which is a version control system. You can have another tools also like SVN, subversion. It is also a version control system. Whatever the change which we are implementing or whatever the file which we are creating, we are committing to that particular Git. Then Git is going to take care of versioning. If any point, if you want to have a track, who modified which file, what time or anything, you can easily track. Like within the team, that is nothing but a collaboration. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Any questions, guys, regarding Git? Git, we are here. We are covering in depth. Okay. We are learning how to manage Git using UI as well as command line. In real time, most of the guys are not going to perform the activities on a command. UI. We need to learn how to use command line. That we are learning. Jenkins. Jenkins is another tool. It is a build automation tool. Like I will give you a short example. let's take, there are two type of frameworks which are available, which is Maven and Ant. Maven is one framework, Ant is another framework in Java. Usually using these frameworks, we are able to compile the Java code. Okay, let's take, can someone please tell me, if Java developer is there, if they, he want to write the source code, what is the file extension? Any idea?
Dot Java.
Perfect. Dot Java files. Okay. Can we directly run the dot Java file?
Java compiler.
Correct. First of all, we need to compile it. Otherwise, it won't run. That using Java C, we are able to compile it. Then what is the file it is going to produce after compilation?
Object file.
Dot class file.
Dot class file.
Dot class file. It is going to generate dot class file. Okay. Now, we cannot deploy or we cannot run thousands of class files. Why? Because if you take in one project, you have thousands of class files. You cannot run those things. We need to pack those class files into a one package. Like jar is, you heard about jar, J-A-R, jar file. That is nothing but a collection of class files. How you are going to create the jar file? Using this framework. Whether you are going to use Ant or whether you are going to Maven, that is not our part. Whatever the Java developer is going to there, right? He is going to, whenever you are going to start the project, he is going to choose which version of which framework which we need to put. Okay, earlier everyone is going to pick Ant, that is very legacy. And now every person which migrated, most of the persons are migrated, most of the projects are migrated to Maven framework. Why? Because it's very flexible and there are a lot of advantages which we are going to see later onwards. Now, whatever the framework it was, using that framework, we are able to compile it and it is going to produce a jar file. Okay, there are other types of files also available, which is var file, er file, or maybe a SAR file. Like, what is mean by WAR file? Web archive. Web archive means nothing but a collection of jar files plus JSPs, Java Servlet Pages. ER, Enterprise Archive. It's nothing but a collection of WAR files. Okay, what is mean by SAR files? SAR file is nothing but a collection of jar files plus templates. It is most related to templates point of view. Okay, whatever the files it was, depending upon the framework, it is going to produce the respective file, maybe a jar file or var file, er file or sar file, whatever it may be. Okay, any questions till now? To compile the code, we are going to run MVM commands. Okay, earlier we are going to run those commands manually, MVM, and we are going to do build.xml. We are calling pom.xml, MVM deploy and pom.xml. Whenever you are executing that type of command, it will automatically compile the code and it will produce an artifact file. Artifact file is nothing but a var file or er file or jar file or whatever the sar file, whatever it may be. Okay. Whatever the manual process which is there, right, which we are automating using Jenkins. That's why we can call it Jenkins is a build automation tool. We are learning how we are going to, using this particular tool, we are automating that build, sorry, deployment automation. Like whatever the build which you are doing here, we are automating using by creating the particular projects here. We are giving git URL and all those stuff, and we are working like that. Okay, any questions regarding Jenkins? We are learning how to use plugins, how to integrate Jenkins, how to create projects on top of it, what are all the scenarios and all the stuff. And also we are going to, from Jenkins, we automatically deploy the var files to a Tomcat application servers. And also we are able to build how to create workflows and all the stuff which we are learning. Okay, any questions? Can I move further?
Yeah.
Okay. Nexus. Nexus is also another tool. Like usually Jenkins is going to produce the var files, right? Var file or er or maybe jar file. You can call it as artifact files. Those artifact files, for example, if you are running project 10 times, it is going to produce 10 artifact files. If you are running 100 times, 100 artifact files will be generated. Those artifact files which we are going to store under Nexus. Nexus is a repository server. Okay? Repository server. We have whatever the artifact file it is producing, we are just uploading to Nexus. Nexus is going to maintain the versions of that artifactory files. And Sonar. Sonar is another tool which we are going to integrate to Jenkins. Using this one, usually whenever the Java developer is, any developer which write the code, some person is going to validate the code, right? Earlier, every team lead or project manager or whatever the so-called senior person which is going to do the code verification, but now Sonar is going to perform that activity. It has its own portal. There you are able to see what are all the things and all the stuff. Okay. In this course, we are covering this continuous integration, all these tools. And okay, before moving to continuous delivery, do you have any questions? Please ask me.
So the Sonar is just like an auto-correcting system, like what the errors and the warnings.
It's not auto-correcting system. It will just report. It will generate a report.
Just like what are the errors in the program and the warnings in the program?
Yeah.
Is that what?
It will. Okay. It will, and also it will tell us what is the best practices also.
Okay, fine. So Nexus is the place where we store all the jar files and execution.
You can call it as artifact file. Maybe a jar, er, var, or sar. Whatever the file it was, it is producing by Jenkins. We are storing under Nexus.
And I have one more question, like the whole program, the DevOps program is, are we going to implement in Java?
Most of the projects are Java. This DevOps are not completely related to Java, but if you have developed a VB scripting also, we can integrate to Jenkins.
Okay, fine. Can we move further?
Okay. If you see continuous delivery process, you can see there are three tools, which is Chef, Ansible, and Puppet. These are the automation tools. Okay. Using these tools, like you have in the market, there is another tool also available, which is Salt. I'm not covering Salt here. Why? Because I don't have any real-time exposure towards it. Okay. In this continuous delivery, we are covering Chef, Ansible, and Puppet. Chef is one tool, Ansible is another tool, Puppet is another tool, but it is performing the same task. Whatever the Chef is doing, same Ansible is doing, same Puppet is doing. Okay? And also these three tools are also competitors in the market. Okay? Then why we need to learn three? Why? Because we don't know what client is going to use. Some people will select Chef. Some people will select Ansible, some will select Puppet. Got it? What exactly these tools will do? Yeah.
Anudeep?
Yes.
Do we learn about Docker?
Yes.
Kubernetes?
I will come to that.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. In Chef, we are learning how to write cookbooks and whatever. What is ultimate thing here is we are able to spin up the infrastructure. Infrastructure means creating compute, storage, network. These are all the things dynamically from these automation tools. If you want to create a network, we can create a network. If you want to spin up a virtual machine, we can spin up a virtual machine. Even though after spinning the virtual machine, do you want to install any software on top of it? We can do it. Everything in a one shot. Here we are, that particular process, here we are writing cookbooks. That is the code which we are writing under cookbooks. And Ansible, we are writing playbooks. And Puppet, we are writing under modules. We are writing modules in Puppet. These are all the things which we are covering here. Okay. Ultimate thing is, whatever the task which you are performing, like infrastructure or application provisioning or whatever the thing which we are doing using these automation tools. Chef and Puppet are written on Ruby and Ansible was written on Python. Okay. And Puppet was introduced on 2005 and Chef was introduced on 2009. Ansible was on 2010. And you can obviously see Puppet, what are the drawbacks which are there, which was overcome on Chef, and what are the drawbacks which was overcome on Ansible. Ansible is getting very popular nowadays. Why? Because it was recently acquired by Red Hat. And that is one reason. Another one is it is very easy to learn. And third reason is it is written on Python. Okay. And if you have knowledge, you have good exposure, in-depth knowledge on any of these two tools, Chef or Ansible, that will be good. If you are learning Puppet also, that will be awesome. Okay. But make sure whether you are selecting Chef and Puppet or Ansible or Puppet or Chef or Ansible, make sure that you need to be strong on two tools.
Okay, got it. Anudeep, is it mandatory we should learn Python scripting or
if you know Google? That will be great. But if you see Ansible was written on Python, but we are not writing Python script, Python code. We are writing YAML code here. Okay. The background plugins are developed on Python. If you want to develop plugins, then you need to learn Python. Okay. At this moment, it's not required much. Why? Because there are thousands of plugins which are already developed by community and Ansible team. Okay. If you use existing plugins, that will be more than enough. But if you want to develop your own plugin, that's a rare condition. If you want to develop, you can still develop and you can integrate to Ansible. And even though you can, Ansible is open source and you can contribute that particular plugin also. Okay, any questions?
Even in Jenkins, we use plugins, right? That plugins correct. And this plugins
no.
Differ?
No. That is completely different. This is completely different.
Fine.
Okay, any questions? Okay, can I move further? And also, yes. We are covering
Anudeep, you said that, Anudeep, you said that this left part, GIT, Jenkins, Nexus, Scholar are continuous integration, and Chef, Ansible, Puppet are continuous delivery.
Correct.
See, continuous, can you differentiate?
Okay, if you see software lifecycle, like you have a product that was written in X language, okay, and usually you have released the product to public, you will get some bugs that need to be fixed. And that will need to roll to development environment first. After that, testing QA environment. Then after, we brought production. This cycle will keep on rolling, right?
Yes.
It won't stop. That is continuous integration. Yes. Okay? And if you see continuous delivery, that is nothing but you want infrastructure. Like you want a servers. You need to install softwares on top of it, applications on top of it. These are all covering under continuous delivery. 1 minute, please.
Okay.
Give me a moment. I'm going to
call.
Hello? Yeah, just give me 5 minutes. I'm connecting. Okay. Okay. Any questions or can I move further?
Yeah, you can move on.
Okay. And also we are covering from this Chef, Ansible, Puppet, we usually provision the infrastructure, right? We can provision on-premises like virtualization environment, like VMware environment I have. We are provisioning that infrastructure on top of it. Or we are covering some of the flows in AWS, Amazon Cloud. AWS means Amazon Web Services. we are going to spinning up the instances in AWS, and also we are doing creating network and all the stuff. Like in Amazon, we automate, we dynamically creating the infrastructure. That is the thing which we are covering, cloud part. Okay.
Docker used to cover in AWS.
No. Anadi? Docker is completely different entity.
Yes, it is used to do in AWS, right?
We have one service which usually it is going to give the Docker service also, but more we are going to learn in on-premises Docker.
Okay, fine.
Okay, apart from this, we are covering Docker. All the simulations which we are doing using Vagrant. Vagrant is a tool. If you want to spin up a virtual machine on your laptop, like say we are going to creating a sandbox environment using Vagrant tool. And we are using VirtualBox for virtualization. And also another prerequisite is you need to have minimum 8 GB memory in your laptop or PC, whatever it may be. Okay. Ram, you came from Babu?
No, Rajesh.
Rajesh, okay. Nutaki? Nutaki? Hey, hi, Akil. And what about the...
My name is Shabari. I came from Babu.
Okay.
I'm from Babu.
I think Shabari and Nutaki came from Babu. Okay. This is the thing which we are covering. Babu is going to forward the course curriculum and all the stuff to you. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
And do we have any schedule for this course? Like and within how many days?
If you want to learn from Linux, that will take 60 days. Okay. If you want only the DevOps, that will take 45 days.
Okay. Fine.
Guys, if you can feel to ask questions. Nutaki, do you have any questions? Ram, do you have any questions? Ashwini, any questions?
Right now, no.
Akhil?
No, bro.
Okay, Shabari?
No, sir. Right now, I don't have any queries. Like, if we move further, I think I'll be raising so many.
Of course. Okay, cool. That's it for today. This is the demo, and... If you can talk to Babu or me regarding timings and all the stuff. Ram, I will ping you. Just ping me on my WhatsApp here. Okay. Ashwini and Akhil, I will ping you. Okay.
Okay.
This is completely practical oriented course. The only demo is theory. Okay.
Yeah. And one more thing, and what about the timings? Is it going to be the same time every day or it's going to be shuffled in the mornings and the evenings?
I'm planning for the same time.
Okay. Is it IST time or?
IST 9 p.m.
Okay.
Anirip, can you make it 7:30 IST?
7:30 I will be in office.
Can you move it to 9:30 if not?
9:30 that I can do. 9:30 PM IST. That is what you are asking me, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's fine. 9:30 is fine for me.
only 1 hour per day?
Yeah, only 1 hour per day. Why? Because 1 hour is more than enough. You need to practice after that.
Okay. You will be giving me assignments.
Sorry? It is completely, like I told you, right? It's completely practical oriented and real time scenarios will be there. If you are practicing multiple times only, you are getting. That is more than enough. If you want documentation, I can give you. That is 300 MB documents which are available, but I don't think so. If you really do the practice, then only you are getting. I don't think so. If you are reading, or if you read also, I don't think so. You don't get without practice.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, guys. Let's
connect. Hello.
Yeah.
Anandip, you will be doing the Python scripting.
Like I told you, right? I will do Python also, but the course will drag. Like, it's 60 days, right? If it's already, then again it will go beyond that.
But Python is necessary for automation, bro. Which are all important, at least cover them.
But it will really drag our course. Okay, I will think about it.
Yeah, I don't think so, because Python we can learn online also.
Why? Because if you see, it's already 60 days, right? If you are again dragging, it will go to 70 days.
Even Python we can learn online. It's,
if you want, I can give you the videos and those stuff. I think if it's fine, if you have any questions, I can tell you.
Okay.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, yeah, cool. Let's meet tomorrow at the same time. Okay, thank you, at 9:30 PM IST. Okay, thank you very much.
All right, guys.
Thank you, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Daily, I have whatever the session, like I'm asking you to present the screen. Someone is going to presenting the screen, and whatever the task which you are going, we are going to recording the session and we are going to upload to Google Drive. I'm going to give you the access to Google Drive. At any time, you can comment, see, and most important thing is practice.
Okay.
Okay? Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, guys. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah. Thank you.